So friends, welcome to my YouTube channel, Govind Narayan Purohit, wherein I am hosting lectures on complete series of theriogenology. And in the current series on andrology, we discuss today about the functional anatomy and physiology of the male domestic animals, the tubular ducts. What are the tubular ducts that help in the transport of the semen? Friends, I am Professor G.N. Purohit, the Dean Postgraduate Studies and University Head, Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, Veterinary College, Bikaner, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, Rajasthan, India. So friends, the tubular ducts of the male reproductive organs, they carry the spermatozoa from the testes to the exterior during semen ejaculation. The ducts include the epididymis, the ductus deferens, the ampulla, and the urethra. During the passage of spermatozoa, the ducts and the accessory sex glands, they contribute the fluid secretions to collectively form the seminal plasma. Now the first duct that is attached to the testes is the epididymis. It's the most important duct. The epididymis is a tortuous coiled tubule starting from the proximal portion of the testes and attaching to the ductus deferens or the vas deferens, and it's an important duct which is responsible for the nutrition, maturation, transport and storage of spermatozoa. In this picture you can see this is the testes and this is the caput epididymis or the head of the epididymis. This is the body or the corpus epididymis, and then this is the cauda epididymis, and these are the testicular blood supply, and this is the straight portion of the vas deferens. This is the convoluted portion of the vas deferens to which the epididymis is attached. The epididymis grossly appears an approximately cylindrical organ. The spermatozoa are stored in the epididymis, retain fertilizing capacity for several weeks. And the cauda epididymis contains about 75% of the total epididymal spermatozoa. So the site of storage of spermatozoa is the cauda epididymis or the tail of the epididymis. So here you can see how the epididymis is attached. The efferent ductules of the epididymis has two parts, the efferent ductules and then the ductus epididymis. The efferent ductules, they are attached to the retrotestes, and then they carry the spermatozoa. The ductus epididymis is convoluted at first part and then it joins to form one tubule, the ductus epididymis. It's very long. The epididymis is the first connected to the testes, and then the space between the epididymis and the testicle is known as the testicular bursa. This is the vas deferens to which it is attached, and then the head of the epididymis, and then the body and the tail of the epididymis. So most of the spermatozoa are stored here, and from here they are released outside during ejaculation. The epididymis consists of three parts, as I said earlier, the head, the body and the tail. The head of the epididymis is U-shaped and hidden. The body of the epididymis is also known as the corpora or the corpus, which is cylindrical and visible. And the tail or cauda, which is inverted triangular tubular mass and the site of sperm storage. The epididymis is closely attached by fibrous tissue to the surface of the testes proper. This is continuous with the vas deferens or the ductus deferens. The length of the epididymis varies in different species. In the stallion it is 20 meters, in the bull it is 30 meters, and it is 50 meters in the boar. The rete testes, as I said earlier, join the afferent ductules of the epididymis that enter the head of the epididymis, which continue as straight tubules, and they become highly convoluted and form conical lobules of the epididymis and then open into the single convoluted tubule, the ductus epididymis. The efferent ductules are lined by ciliated tall columnar epithelium, which consists of both absorpted and ciliated cells. So these are the short absorptive cells and these are the tall ciliated cells. The shorter non-ciliated cells along the columnar cells of the efferent ductules absorb the fluid secreted by the seminiferous tubules. The ductus epididymis is lined by very tall pseudostratified columnar epithelium. Most cells of the epithelium are known as the principal cells and have long, they have long stereocilia. And then there are the basal cells which further produce the cells. The tail of the epididymis acts as a reservoir of fully mature sperm and becomes turgid when with stored sperm in sexually active animals. The epididymis function is covered by smooth muscle coat, which transports the sperm by peristaltic movements. It has more secretory and absorptive activity. The epididymal duct provides the environment for gaining of fertility by the spermatozoa. Now, these are the functions of the epididymis. There is absorption, secretion, maturation of the spermatozoa, transport of the spermatozoa, and storage of fertile spermatozoa in the tail of the epididymis. So here you can see the caput. In the caput of the epididymis, there is fluid absorption and sperm chromatin compaction. In the corpus, there is protein synthesis, vesicle secretion, acquisition of sperm progressive motility, and sperm chromatin compaction. Then the defense response also appears in the sperm in this section. The cauda is the portion of the sperm storage, and then there is further sperm chromatin compaction, and there is defense response and sperm quality control. So how the sperms are removed from the spermatozoa, how the sperm are removed from the epididymis? The sperms are removed at the time of mating by ejaculation, and then there is periodic contractions on the epididymis, resulting in gradual tickle of the spermatozoa out of the tail through the into the pelvic urethra, where they are flushed out of the tract during urination. So some of them they come out, they are flushed out by during urination. This allows removal of sperm on a continual basis. Then the second part is the inguinal canal. The inguinal canal is a slit-like space between the internal and external inguinal ring. Internal inguinal ring is formed by internal oblique abdominal muscle, and external inguinal ring is formed by tendons of the external oblique abdominal muscle. In the dog, bull, and boar, the internal inguinal ring is larger, but they have a shorter inguinal canal. In the stallion, the inguinal canal is longer, but it has smaller internal inguinal ring. So through this, they pass through the inguinal canal. Then the vas deferens or the ductus deferens is a siphon-shaped structure for the exit of spermatozoa. It passes parallel, it is, attaches to the epididymis and passes parallel to the testes into the spermatic cord. This is spermatic cord. Through the inguinal canal, then this is the inguinal canal, and dorsomedially to the neck of the urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder to the neck of the urinary bladder. It has uniform thickness up to urinary bladder. This is 3 mm in bulls and 6 mm in the stallion. The vas deferens is supplied by blood, by internal pudic artery and spermatic artery, and the nervous supply is pelvic plexus. The vas deferens connects the ductus epididymis to the urethra. It opens at colliculus seminalis, and there is a dilation in some species called the ampulla. The colliculus seminalis is a sphincter-like structure present near the urinary bladder, and it closes the urinary bladder during ejaculation of the semen so that no urine is mixed in the semen or sperm enters into the urinary bladder. Then the dilated part of the dwarf deferens is known as the ampulla, and there are in some species there are the ampullary glands also. The union of the vas deferens with the duct of the seminal vesicle with a common excretory passage lateral to the colliculus seminalis in some species, humans, is known as ejaculatory duct, but such ejaculatory duct is not found in most domestic animal species. The ductus deferens consists of an adventitia. This is the adventitia, a muscular tunic, and a mucous membrane. This is the mucosa. These are the longitudinal and the circular muscles. The mucosa of the vas deferens forms low longitudinal folds and lined by pseudostratified columnar epithelium. This is the pseudostratified columnar epithelium, and the cells also have the stereocilia. The terminal fusiform and large glandular portion of the vas deferens is known as ampulla of the vas deferens. In the bull, the ampulla has a length of 10 to 15 cm and a diameter of 1 to 1.5 cm. In the stallion, the length is 15 to 20 cm and diameter is 2 to 2.5 cm. It is smaller in boars. Ampulla lies dorsal to the urinary bladder and passes beneath the body of the prostate and opens in the round prominence into the pelvic urethra known as the colliculus seminalis. The ampulla is absent in the dog and the cat. Then lastly, the urethra, where from the semen it passes outside. The urethra in males is the common passage for the excretion of urine as well as for transport of semen. It is about 115 cm length in bulls. And urethra has three distinct parts. The pelvic part over here. Then the bulb of the urethra. This is the bulb of the urethra. And then this is the penile part. The pelvic urethra is enclosed by heavy urethral muscle, also known as the Wilson's muscle, which helps in ejaculation and micturition by its forcible contraction. The bulb of the urethra is extrapelvic, situated at the ischial arch, and is bending ventral to the pelvis. This is the bulb. The penile urethra runs inside the penis proper. This is the penis. So let us hurriedly recapitulate what we have learned in today's lecture. The ducts of the male reproductive tract include the epididymis, the ductus deferens or the vas deferens, ampulla, and the urethra. The epididymis connects from the retitestes to the vas deferens and has three parts, the head, body, and tail. The efferent ducts of the epididymis enter the head and join a single duct, the ductus epididymis, which is long. The epididymis performs the function of sperm maturation and storage in the tail of the epididymis. The inguinal canal is a slit-like space between the internal and external inguinal ring. The vas deferens is a tubular duct that connects from the tail of epididymis and opens at the colliculus seminalis. It has a dilated ampulla in some species. The urethra is the common duct for the passage of the urine and has the pelvic part, bulb, and the penile part. So you can contact me at my email gnpobs@gmail.com. This is my LinkedIn link and this is my YouTube channel link. So kindly listen to the lecture completely. Give your views, comments, share the video, give your suggestions, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Govind Narayan Purohit, if you like them. Thank you so much.